pi as a constant is not terribly difficult to understand because it's defined by geometry, the ratio between the circumference and the diameter of a circle. But there's another super vital constant in math, Euler's number, or E, which is 2.71828, and it goes on. Unlike pi, E isn't defined by geometry, but by growth. Now, how does this work? The story of E goes back to Jacob Bernoulli in the late 17th century, who's interested in compounding interest. So let's say that we have an interest rate of 100% every year. While this may seem unrealistic for banks, it's not uncommon in nature. For instance, population growth can have a doubling factor of 100% since organisms literally double in number. Anyways, if we put $1 into this bank account and we assume that the interest is calculated yearly, at the end of the year, we'll have $2, right? But what if it calculated the interest twice a year instead? By the 6th month, we'd have $1 plus the 50% interest, or $1.50. And at the end of the year, another 50% of interest accrues, so we get $2.25. This relationship can be summed up by this equation. If we want to compound 4 times a year, using this equation, we get $2.44. 8 times, $2.56. What about every day, 365 times? Then we get 2.714. If we keep compounding to bigger and bigger numbers, what we're doing is essentially taking the limit to infinity. We eventually get, when we take that limit, that it equals 2.71828182828, and it goes on, which is just Euler's number. Euler's number is a universal constant that emerges whenever there's continuous natural growth, where compounding happens at every moment. When we took that limit to infinity, essentially what we were saying is that it compounds infinite times in that year, so it's constantly compounding. Whether it's the growth of populations, investments, or any phenomenon that allows for an exponential pattern, E encapsulates this organic progression. It's a fundamental building block in mathematics, appearing in various contexts where growth is the key. In calculus, E has enormous significance as well. Let's take a look at the graph of y equals e to the power of x. Let's just choose any value in the graph, like x equals 1.5, for no particular reason. It doesn't really matter what point we choose on the graph, because it'll apply to anything. If we find the value of the function at 1.5, find the instantaneous rate of change at 1.5, which is the slope of the tangent line as shown, and we find the area of the curve up until that point as shown in pink, we find something really interesting. They are all equal to the same value. Essentially what we're saying is that the derivative, integral, and value of y equals e to the x at any point on the graph are equal to each other. This elegant property means that the rate of growth of e to the x is proportional to its current value, making it a natural representation of continuous growth. In simpler terms, as x increases, e to the x grows at a rate proportional to its current size, mirroring the way that many natural phenomena evolve over time. This property of e to the x makes it indispensable in calculus. It seamlessly describes rates of change and dynamic growth, emphasizing the inherent link between Euler's number and the concept of natural growth that permeates many aspects of our world and mathematics.